Hello, folks, and thank you for stopping by. Well, we're doing another reaction video, and this time around, we basically doing another hit that my wife thought of, and it's back in the day, apparently, you know, it was one of those very popular songs that everybody danced to and everything, and of course, the name of the song is...
Ain't No Stopping Us Now by McFadden and Whitehead. Yay!
So we definitely doing that one and everything. And of course, now before we go into that quote, I always got to point to this thing right here. Check that out and everything. So, onward and forward to our video. And of course, the video is McFadden Whitehead. Ain't No Stopping Us Now. Blase, blase. So, well, let's get at it. Let's have some fun. Hope y'all ready. Oh, no, it's the girl, the backup. They sang in their head.
This came out in the summer.
The summertime? Oh, wow. And there they are. Philadelphia sound. Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay. They putting them dance moves in, aren't they? Wow. Oh, what? Whoa. I'm doing a little sound like Peter there, right? She's like a walking encyclopedia of music. Wow. Y'all saw the last video, you already know what I'm talking about. Oh man. Let me stop. Stop. Wow.
Let me tell y'all something. They developed the Philadelphia sound. You ever heard of that? It was music that came like from, I'm going to think of their name in a minute. They wrote a lot of songs for other people before they did this for themselves, you know, and they wrote songs for a lot of groups. A lot of them the names are on my mouth, but I gotta slow down. I really do, because they wrote for what's that group name? Teddy Pendergrass and the How Melvin and the Blue Notes. They wrote for, oh God, please let these names come to my mind. Anybody that was starting out in Philadelphia, they wrote, it was called the Philadelphia Sound. That I know because I watch a lot of YouTube, that show I told y'all to look
Unsung.
Up. Unsung.
Unsung.
And they both died. One of them died, they had a sickness. The one that wasn't doing all that moving, he died because he had a sickness. The other one died, he got killed. Somebody, he was fixing his car, somebody came behind him and shot him.
Wow.
You know, his daughter said that on Unsung.
Woo.
And a lot of this music that you hear during that time in the 1970s, this is the 1970-something song, I believe. Yeah, because I was a teenager. I was like 15, 1976, 1975.
Okay.
I was a teenager. And we used to, my mother and them used to give these outings, these picnics. And we was on one time, and I had a boyfriend, and he didn't want to go and listen to it. I said, okay, you stay. I went out. Me and my cousin, we went, and we danced to it and everything. But they developed the sound of Philadelphia, them and a couple others. But I remember them because they wrote for Teddy Pendergrass. They wrote for Hal Melvin and the Blue Notes. I don't think they do the Whispers. They did Shoo Shoo Shine, used to cost a dime, a penny. I think they wrote for them too. I'm not sure, but you can look it up on Unsung. And you can learn everything you want about them. But they used to write a lot of music for people in the 1970s. Okay? So you don't have to take my word. You can look it up on Unsung. Like I always tell you, this is what I heard on Unsung. But you can look it up on there, and they will tell you exactly who McFadden and Whitehead was. And that's all I have for you today. Peace.
I am married to a music encyclopedia.
No, you're not. I just know things because when I like something and it comes on TV, I immediately get into it. And I you need to do that because when people ask you questions, I said, no, that's not what happened. I know you can't believe anything you hear on TV, but then when they get up and they say it, his daughter said it, and the children say it, so they can't be wrong.
That's something interesting. Oh, wow. You know, when we look at singers in general and everything, we have no idea what's going on in their lives.
We sure don't.
We don't. And when they're able to go out there and make the music like they do, it's just call it a miracle.
Yeah, and sometimes they don't even get paid what they're worth. They go bankrupt, and things of that nature. And they have kids, And that's why I tell people, if you're going to be in this business, take care of your own business. You don't need nobody to take care of your money. Take your own money. You're not taking your money. You ain't that freaking busy.
Okay, we heard that, folks.
But my son, he's an artist. He does plays and he sings. I said, take care of your own money or let your mama take care of it. You know, make somebody who you love and trust that you know it's not going to mess up your money. Let them take care of it.
Okay. See, we're learning something here. See, always learning. Every time this lady stops by, we always learning something. Aren't we?
Don't stop by. You ask me, do I want to do
it? I beg and plead. Okay, I admit it. I beg and plead. Please, please help me do this video.
He don't beg me, people. He asks me, and I say yes. Don't make me seem like you beg and plead me to do anything, boo-boo.
Okay. Well, thank you for stopping by.
Don't make me seem like I
love messing with her.
Do anything.
I like messing with
her. Because I love you.
Oh, I love you too, baby. All right, thank you. All right, so we'll let y'all get along with your day. Thank you for stopping by. And don't let anything depress you. And, you know, peace.
Right, that's what I say, peace. And have a very, very wonderful day in God. Love you.